Hi everyone, in this tutorial I'll show how we can stitch this shower cap. In general we'll be using some plastic bags, make a knot, and this and all will create a mess up right when we apply some heat dyes or masks etc. So it's better to customize it using some waterproof material. So let's see how we can stitch this. I'll show how we can customize the shower cap as per our head size. For this I'm using a doll. First we need to measure the diameter of our head size. To get that, start from the crown part and move on backwards like this, such that you will meet the crown point again. So it is approximately 14 inches. This is how I measure. Starting from this point, move on to the back and again back to the crown point. So it is approximately 14 inches. So diameter is 14 inches. Radius, which is half of the diameter, is 7 inches plus 1 inch I am taking it as seam 11. So total will be 8 inches. We have to cut a circle based on this radius. Since it's not very easy to cut the circle based on the given radius, what we can do is we can cut a square piece based on the radius. The square measurements will be twice the radius plus 1. So it will be 8 plus 1, 2 into 9, it is 18 inches. So first cut out a square which is of 18 inches. After that I will show how we can cut the circle out of that. Assume that this is 18 inches square piece. Now fold it twice. Again fold it. So total it is of 4 layers. Now from the closed part, not the open one, closed part, mark the radius, that is 8 inches. We have to mark 8 inches all over this like a curve. Now join these dots. This is how we can simply cut a circle out of the square piece. Now using this paper pattern, cut two circles out of the fabric. By following that method, I cut two circles as per my head size. Now place right sides facing together and do a top stitch all around the outer circle by leaving a gap of 1 inch here. I am done with the stitching. If you find it hard to take it inside out from the 1 inch gap, even you can leave 2 inch gap so that you can easily pull out it. I left a 2 inch gap here. Now turn it inside out through this gap. After turning it completely, we have to create an elastic casing on the edge portion. For this I am using 1/2 inch elastic. So what you can do is, from the stitching mark, you can leave 0.6 inch and do a top stitch all over the circle such that it will be 0.6 inches from the stitching mark. Once done, we have to insert the elastic. Pin this to the gap insert inside the casing. Once done with inserting the elastic, take both the ends of the elastic such that both are in same direction. Join these two ends by doing multiple zigzag stitches. After concealing the elastic, pull it inside the casing and close the gap created.